Hi there. Now, an incredible and terrifying story, and this morning, close to a happy ending. In the last hour, Sahil Saeed, the boy kidnapped in Pakistan, you remember, has been reunited with his father. Now, we have these new pictures. They were taken about 40 minutes ago. We understand he's now on his way to the airport to fly back home. But there he is, 5 years old, being looked after at the British High Commission in Islamabad and reunited with his dad. It's the first time Sahil's been seen in public since he was found wandering alone in a field 13 days after being kidnapped, and what a long 13 days they were for his family. Now, Sahil and his father will fly home to the UK later today, and he's expected to be met at Manchester Airport by his mum, who stayed back in Alton with his other children when he arrived early this evening, and she did say that she would only believe he was safe when she saw him with her own eyes. So that would be a very, very emotional reunion, I'm sure. Lovely to see them back together again. Now, psychologist James Thompson joins us now. Those are the pictures we've been waiting to see, aren't they?
Absolutely
fantastic. What do you think? I know you're just looking at pictures, but how do you think he's holding up looking at those pictures?
On the basis of those pictures, I'd say this is fine. This is a child who's been held in probably reasonable circumstances, and we're seeing him again in an absolutely normal way. Of course, I know you can't make a judgment on the basis of that. We still need some weeks, but at the moment, it looks good.
He's 5 years old. Now, is he young enough to forget his ordeal? Is he old enough to cope with it and process it?
We know that kids can remember their fourth birthday and things after their fourth birthday, generally for the rest of their lives. So he will remember this stuff. And remember, it is probably a very violent episode when the robbers first came. And then we don't know what's happened to him and how he was held. He could have been in bad circumstances, or it could have been just in a backyard where he was treated reasonably well. In a sense, if it was an entirely commercial operation, they might have just put him out with some other kids to play. We don't know how this has been done. But the look of him is he was not kept, as sometimes children are kept, in a small box or container and maltreated in any way.
Thank goodness, thank goodness. Now, he was with his dad, of course, when he was kidnapped. How will this affect their relationship? They look to be delighted to be with each other in those pictures there, but is there a problem there?
It will probably be fine, but the father may feel that he failed in the essential thing a dad has to do, which is to protect a child, and he was obviously overwhelmed. Also, there's a chance, it's not high, but it's there, that the kid will think, perhaps I did something wrong. Children, when there are disruptions, often think, well, it's me again, isn't it? So he might think some punishment was being handed out. And so there's a little bit of explanation to be given there. But it could be that this is one of those things where the child's construction of what happened is a benign one. Well, there was a problem, but it's sorted. And it's the rest of us who understood what risk he was at.
And basic advice for the family and for the boy going forward, will they need therapy? Would you advise them?
I would say bring the extended family in, talk, listen, never turn a subject down because it's unpleasant. Just chat. And it's only a month or two later, if things are still going wrong or wrong at all, that you would get someone, probably someone they already know, a nurse or someone who they've already had contact with, and that would be the proper channel.
James, very good to speak to you this morning. Thank you very much indeed.